Hi everyone, it's Harry here from Year 13 and I have Abby with me on behalf of the Australian Nursing and Midwifery Federation of South Australia. It's a non-government organisation that represents nurses, midwives and personal care assistants across South Australia. So welcome, Abby.
Hello, thank you for having me.
No problem. Before we get stuck in, I'd love for you to tell me a bit about yourself, your kind of journey post-school, you know, what you're studying and where.
Yep, so my name's Abby Bazenshaw and I'm currently 19 years old. I graduated high school in 2019 and I'm currently studying the Diploma of Nursing through ANMEC, the SA branch. I've previously completed a Certificate 3 in Individual Support Aged Care sector in 2018 when I was in Year 11 through the same organisation. I'm very much enjoying this so far and, yeah, look forward to see what's next.
Fantastic, fantastic. It's great to hear that people are getting engaged in these sort of studies during school and not just after school.
It's exactly right.
Yeah, it's fantastic to hear that ANMEC provide these opportunities to students. It's a great way to kickstart your career and also get a taste for what is to come potentially if you do further studies.
Yeah.
So, you know, you're excited about what's ahead. You've done a couple of courses so far starting in 11. You know, about what you've studied so far and what you're currently working on makes you excited or inspired and, you know, motivated to pursue a career in nursing?
Well, ANMEC was really good because when I did my Cert 3 back in 2018, it was mainly about the aged care section, but it really did give me those like basic nursing skills that I am using now in my diploma. So having that background when I first started, I think I started last year, so I'm in my second year now, so I graduate in a few months. It really did help me with this course especially, and it's like a really good mind refresher in a way. ANMEC's been really supportive in that way, and I definitely am glad that I chose to do that when I was in Year 11.
Fantastic, fantastic. So, yeah, it does help, you know, set you up for your career in the future.
Yeah, definitely does, yeah.
Great, great. Now, speaking of school, and you know, I know you started studying when you were in that industry when you were in Year 11. Were there any particular subjects that prepared you particularly for your career of becoming a nurse?
Yeah. So when I was in school, during Year 12 in particular, I was told by many teachers that it's best to keep subjects such as like biology and maths even, because both of these are key components nurses and even carers use each day. And I found that biology in particular helped me quite a lot because in relation to like human anatomy and function of organs and things, these are all definitely brought up multiple times during any nursing course that anyone will do. So it definitely allowed me to feel a lot more familiar when these subjects were introduced in my current course. Maths as well also was very helpful because everyone uses it every day. So when we were doing like drug calculations, it was just really good to have that background knowledge on just basic math skills. So yeah, definitely recommend those two subjects, and yeah, it just really does help for the long run.
Yeah, fantastic. I can imagine the application of, you know, your basic general mathematics and some of the introductory things you learn in biology would come in, you know, come in handy.
And
it's great to know that as a student you can go to your, you know, your careers counselor or your teacher and say, you know, I'm looking to pursue, you know, a path down a nursing or something to that effect, and they can direct you into particular areas of focus at school. So it's great to know that there are school subjects that facilitate that learning in the early stage.
Yeah, definitely.
Now, you know, speaking of your vet programs that you did at school, you know, what are the main benefits of doing this?
Yeah, so there are definitely many benefits to doing a vet course in school program. I would definitely recommend this to anyone who has a sort of like a plan on what they'd like to do after graduation. It allows students to study separately from school and really give them an insight on what study is like after school. It also provides them with another qualification that can be completed part-time within 1 year, depending on the type of course that they choose. For me personally, I found this to be really rewarding because I made friends along the way that were heading in the same direction as I. There's even a few people I know that is in my current Diploma of Nursing that's going on the same pathway as me, through the same organisation as well. And it can be quite flexible because it is school-based. So they do mainly like maybe 2 days a week. So it's really flexible between school days and school hours. Once I completed my certificate three, I was then in year 12 and I already had held like a qualification in aged care that would allow me to begin my healthcare career. So it's very beneficial, school-based program. So I definitely recommend it.
Wow. Yeah. It sounds as such that you can, you know, continue your standard studies, and also kickstart your career. So when you do leave school, you're already kind of ahead of the pack with regards to. And you can start working, I imagine. You can start to, you know, support yourself in that. You know, were you able to, once you finished school, did you have any skills you could apply in like in an employment position?
Yeah. So when I did my, I had a 4-week placement in my certificate three in an aged care facility. Oh. And when I was actually on placement, they offered me a position as a carer. So that's also basically almost like an automatic advantage in a way, and really gives you like the extra experience if you're heading into the nursing career. So it's really, really, really rewarding.
Well done for that. That's fantastic. And yeah, you're right. Because otherwise you'd have to maybe, you know, potentially have a different job to, you know, supplement your studies and income and support yourself. So it makes sense to be able to work in the industry you're also studying in. You know, both of them feed each other. You learn more and you get more experience in it. It kind of, it's a win-win.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. So, you're coming up to graduation, you know, soon, you're still in your studies. Mm-hmm. What are you most excited about? Is it getting into the workforce? Is it applying all the things you've learned into, you know, helping patients?
Yep. So, when I graduate in August this year, I'm definitely most looking forward to receiving my qualification award and finally being able to practice my nursing skills within a workplace environment. Definitely as a student during clinical placements that I've done previously, I learned so much all on nursing techniques and was able to practice on patients and administer medication as well as just apply my knowledge to basic nursing care. So I'm definitely most looking forward to kickstarting my nursing career and once I graduate this August and just being able to finally become independent in a way and just get more experience, especially at such a young age as well, definitely help me for the long run.
Yeah, absolutely. That's well, good luck for your final kind of studies up until August.
Yeah,
that's
thank you.
Exciting.
Yeah.
So for those individuals thinking about a career in nursing, or in the aged care kind of industry and profession, what advice would you have for them?
So to anyone who is thinking of studying nursing or becoming a carer even, I would say it's definitely a challenging course. However, in the end, is the most rewarding thing you can do. I would advise people to try and finish high school and get their high school diploma, as well as keep up with the subjects I suggested as before, such as biology and maths. And to just take every opportunity there is to find and just gain extra experience, because extra experience can't go wrong at all. It's so rewarding and beneficial for the long run, definitely for extra experience. Even doing school-based vet programs as well, getting those extra qualifications through school at a young age will definitely look good for the future as well and for future employers. Taking the time out of the week to study is extremely important as well. It'll just help you keep your mind fresh, and especially when you go out to clinicals on clinical placements, there's nothing worse than going out there and just not knowing anything. So I think it's really, really good to just, even during the week, just take a few hours and just keep your mind up to date. This will all help in the long run and will all be completely worth it all in the end.
Yeah, that's great advice, Abby, to continually keep fresh and also current with what you're studying. And you know, also allows you to practice some discipline, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a fantastic skills that'll help you in your career, but also, you know, in your life to come. And so that's advice for these individuals looking to pursue a career in nursing, or in being a carer. So, you know, you did your vet in schools program placements and you then went into studying with ANMEC. You know, what are the reasons that led you to choose to study with the Australian Nursing and Midwifery Education Centre?
Yes, so I first found out about ANMEC SA branch through my school during one of the uni open days that was held. And some friends and I were all interested in initially starting a certificate three, as we were all told it'd be beneficial for the future. So we were all interested in nursing in the future as well. So we all kind of applied and just started that together. ANMEC was a very good choice in the end, as it was a school-based program. So it was not overloading or overwhelming in a way. So they were very flexible. And once I graduated high school, it wasn't initially in my plan to go back to ANMEC to do Diploma of Nursing. However, I did my research online before I made any big decisions regarding my future studies, and in the end decided that ANMEC was the best way to go. I found this because I've always loved the support provided from the educators in ANMEC, from what I remember during my Cert 3 as well. And yeah, it just has always drawn me towards studying there because I'd rather do my enrolled nursing first, which ANMEC was able to provide me, and then go on to doing 2 years of registered nursing. So yeah, ANMEC is definitely a welcoming to all type of organisation, and it just felt right to start my nursing education through them.
Fantastic. Yeah, it sounds like they've got a great kind of opportunity to get young individuals into the workforce and studying down that kind of career path of nursing, midwifery and aged care. So, yeah. You know, for an individual looking to get engaged with ANMEC, would you suggest just going online, finding their website and inquiring that way, or is that
the best way to get involved? Yeah, so if anyone wants to find any more information regarding ANMEC or ANMFSA, just looking it up on Google, come up with their main homepage, and they have all their branches on there as well. And they have all the information about the education courses you can choose. And they have a many variety of courses. They have the Cert 3 still available. They still have the Diploma of Nursing. They have an advanced Diploma of Nursing for already enrolled nurses that want to continue on with their career path.
Wow.
So yeah, it has a lot of information. It has all of the course updates on what the course actually includes and placements and everything, and it has all the info you would need on the homepage.
That's brilliant. So that's the Australian Nursing Midwifery Education Centre, ANMEC. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Now, Abby, I've got one last question for you. So with your graduation coming up this August,
yep.
I know you're really excited to get stuck in and apply all the things you've learned over your years of study and, you know, develop that independence as a nurse. What does that look like for you? You know, is there a particular place you'd like to work? Is there an area you'd like to focus on over the next, you know, 1 to 2 years? What's that plan look like for you?
Yep. So currently I am a carer at Helping Hand Powerful Gardens. And so once I graduate in August this year, hopefully in the next 1 or 2 years, I hope to have hopefully landed a job opportunity in enrolled nursing, hopefully at the same place that I'm working now, while at the same time studying my Bachelor of Registered Nursing at university. And because of this course, it actually allows me guaranteed entry into second year registered nursing because I'm already qualified enrolled nurse, which is another benefit as well to doing this course.
Nice.
And yeah, by this time, I hope to have gained at least 1 or more years of enrolled nursing experience that I can use for my registered nursing training, and hopefully then move into this once I've graduated my registered nursing. I'm not exactly sure yet what area of nursing I would like because there is so many to choose from and so many to work in. But when I know, I'll know, and I'll definitely work my way towards that. But yeah, I'm really hoping to just work as an enrolled nurse after August this year, hopefully, and just gain as much experience as I possibly can before I'm a registered nurse.
Absolutely. I've got no doubt you will, you know, find that particular niche that you're best suited for and you're most passionate about. And it's fantastic to hear that you've got all these opportunities that you know, through ANMEC and through your in-schools vet programs that allow you to open up doors in the future, you know, accelerate programs. It means you can, you know, wow, okay, you've done this for your practical placement has then given you access to a guaranteed spot in this program. So it's really good to think that there are these stepped out, clear, defined opportunities available. And it's not as scary or unknown as people may assume. So
All it takes
is to talk to your career advisor or get online and have a look, and you know, things do open up.
Yeah, definitely. Well, even in year 12, I didn't know that doing this course was an option to get into uni as well, because I thought initially it was just going to uni and getting in or not getting in at all and then having no idea where to go. But when I found out about ANMEC, all the educators and all the people that are within the organisation told me, like, of all the different pathways you can possibly go from here. And it's not even ANMEC. You can go through TAFE and through so many other places as well. For me, ANMEC was my best choice. But, yeah, I think a lot of students don't realise that it's not just school and then uni. Like, there's so many organisations to go through, and I'm really happy that I went through ANMEC first before uni.
Good on you, Abby. Yeah, and it sounds that these alternative pathways are, you know, equally as beneficial for your career and also for hopefully, you know, if you do want to continue your studies at a tertiary level, go to university one day.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
That's really great to know. And it's good to know for the future generations that there are multiple avenues available to pursue a career or a passion in nursing that are not just limited to those, you know, as we said, the university pathway. So yeah. I think that just about covers everything for us today, Abby. I really appreciate your time and, you know, the fact that you were able to share your experience, your advice, you know, the amount you've learned and the amount you can kind of, you know, bring to your profession is pretty impressive that, you know, even though you only graduated from high school not long ago. So
yeah,
it's fantastic to see, you know, young professionals coming up through the system that are really passionate about what they do. And they're, you know, there's these fantastic pathways that are able to support that and provide all the, you know, education and support and experience necessary to, you know, give you that platform to, you know, dive into your career head first, hopefully in August, September.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you for that. Yeah,
perfect.
I really hope so.
Yeah, no, I've no doubt. And I'd also like to thank the Australian Nursing and Midwifery Federation of South Australia for providing us this opportunity to speak today. It's been really great. So again, thank you so much, Abby, and have a lovely day.
No worries. Thank you.